someone once asked me if I was trying to break into a man's world when I said I was going to study an engineering subject as a master's degree. And it was just something that, I mean, it was actually quite easy to ignore him because it was someone who didn't really know much about science. And it was something I really wanted to do, so I didn't let it put me off and just carried on.
I don't think there was a time when I ever, when I ever thought I'd do anything else.
Just working outdoors, travelling internationally to exotic places, I pretty quickly fell in love with volcanology specifically.
But I kept finding myself asked the question, how do those weather people know that the weather is going to do that? So I turned a career into finding out how those weather people knew what the weather was going to do.
When I was 12 years old, the movie Twister came out and I saw it three times at the movies. I was like, wow, there's this whole world of weather out there and I could actually have a career in science and weather. And I said to my mum, that's it, I'm going to be a meteorologist.
When we used to have family gatherings, it was really traditional. So after dinner, all the women went into the kitchen and they started doing the dishes and preparing dessert. But I used to stay at the table with the men because I was so awestruck by the stories that they used to tell about their workplaces and their experiences. So I grew up wanting to be just like my grandfather and my uncles and my dad as well. My dad, he's a farmer, so that's where I got my interest in weather and climate.
I was just passing at the start of high school, and then I think somewhere around year 9 or 10, I did really well on a physics test in science, and I thought, hey, this is a nice feeling. And that really encouraged me to keep going, and I really enjoyed it. And that's probably why I'm here today. It was just having a good teacher who was really encouraging and just liking the subject.
It's often a key individual who just, you know, light the spark that takes you to the next level. Yeah.
I wasn't actually naturally gifted at maths and physics, which I needed to be able to do to get into the bureau. And all through high school, I really struggled, and there weren't many other girls in my class that I could talk about it with. So luckily I had my mum, who was a really big supporter of me, and also my teachers, which really helped me get through and get the marks I needed to get into the bureau.
More recently, there are a lot more women getting involved in geology, especially volcanology. I definitely had female mentors and coaches when I was back at university, which really helped me see what the pathways could be for a female studying volcanology.
If I could tell my 13-year-old self something today, it would be to make sure that you keep working hard, because even though things can be a little bit challenging sometimes, hard work really can help you get to where you want to be in your career.
Have more confidence in your ability. When I was in my teenage years and my early 20s, I had a lot of self-doubt, and it held me back in some ways. There were opportunities which I didn't take, which in retrospect I probably should have.
Don't compare yourself so much to other people, because there'll always be people who are better than you and people who are worse than you, and it's just about maximising your own potential. So, you know, as long as you do the best you can in everything, then that's all that anyone can ask for, really.
If you don't believe in yourself, no one else will. You know, if you let those chinks show, other people will fill them up.
A strong female is one who goes out there and aspires in her career, aspires in having opinions and a great attitude to life.
To give it a crack, because you never know, this could end up being your dream job one day.